Good evening, friends. Today we celebrate the solemnity of All Saints. It is a holy day for Catholics when we celebrate the Church triumphant, the acknowledged saints who are enjoying the beatific vision in heaven. We all have this universal call to holiness. What must we to do in order to join the company of the saints in heaven? We must follow in his footsteps. We must devote ourselves with all our being to the glory of God and to the service of our neighbor. In this way, the holiness of the people of God will grow into an abundant harvest of good, as is admirably shown by the life of so many saints. Let us then pray to the general body of saints, asking them to help us in all our endeavor to sainthood.
Bring out your joy, give glory to God, lift up your hearts and sing. Let all creation tell of his name, praise him forevermore. Blessed are you, God of our fathers, glory and praise forevermore. Blessed your great and glorious holy name, glory and praise forevermore. Ring out your joy, give glory to God, lift up your hearts and sing. Let all creation tell of his name, praise him forevermore.
This holy mass is offered for the soul of Berta Bosco, death anniversary, for the soul of Rosie Gonsalves, offered by Olga Rodrigues, for the soul of Beatrice Farro, for the souls of John and Antonia Serrao, for the soul of Johnny Barreto, for the success in undergoing operation of Clarence Nigrel. Thanksgiving Mass to Mary, help of Christians, on the birthday of Clifford Serrao. Thanksgiving Mass offered by Hugh D'Souza. Thanksgiving Mass to Sacred Heart of Jesus on the birthday of Anderson Rebello. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, today the Church celebrates a great feast. Feast of all the saints. Today, as we look into our own lives, let us ask ourselves, which are the areas that we need to work on so that we too can one day become a saint? For the times that we have faltered, for the times that we have given into our own temptations, let us ask the Lord for his mercy and for his grace. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, Forgive us our sins and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Father, we sing to your name. Wonderful, mighty are you. All of creation with us shouts out your praise. Angels on high, people on earth, things that have life that have not, rally together to sing glory to you. Jesus, your Son, came to earth, bringing your life to our soul. Peace to this world he did give in your great name. Jesus, we sing to your name. Merciful, loving are you. All those you saved in your love bow at your feet. Spirit, we sing to your name. Life-giving, holy are you. Gather all nations of the world into your love. Send us your power, make us new. Pour out your joy in our hearts. Grant us your light to declare Jesus the Lord. Glory to God and peace to men. Glory to God and peace to men.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, by whose gift we venerate in one celebration the merits of all the saints, bestow on us, we pray, through the prayers of so many intercessors, an abundance of the reconciliation with you, for which we earnestly long. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
In the first reading from the book of Revelation, we get a description of heaven and the legions of saints and angels who have been washed in the blood of the Lamb and stand before the throne of Jesus. In the second reading from the letter of Saint John, we are reminded that we are God's children and we receive the promise that we will become like Him.
A reading from the book of the Apocalypse. I, John, saw another angel rising where the sun rises, carrying the seal of the living God. He called in a powerful voice to the four angels whose duty was to devastate land and sea. Wait before you do any damage on land or at sea or to the trees, until we have put the seal on the foreheads of the servants of our God. Then I heard how many were sealed. 144,000 out of all the tribes of Israel. After that, I saw a huge number, impossible to count, of people from every nation, race, tribe, and language. They were standing in front of the throne and in front of the Lamb, dressed in white robes and holding palms in their hands. They shouted aloud, "Victory to our God, who sits on the throne, and to the Lamb." And all the angels who were standing in a circle round the throne, surrounding the elders and the four animals, prostrated themselves before the throne and touched the ground with their foreheads, worshipping God with these words, "Amen, praise and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and strength to our God forever and ever. Amen." One of the elders then spoke and asked me, "Do you know who these people are, dressed in white robes, and where they have come from?" I answered him, "You can tell me, my Lord." Then he said, "These are the people who have been through a great persecution, and they have washed their robes white again in the blood of the Lamb." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response to God's word shall be, "Such are the men who seek your face, O Lord." Please repeat.
Such are the men who seek your face, O Lord.
The Lord is the earth and its fullness, the world and all its peoples. It is He who set it on the seas, and the waters He made it firm. Our response.
Such are the men who seek your face, O Lord.
Who shall climb the mountain of the Lord? Who shall stand in His holy place? The man with clean hands and pure heart, who desires not worthless things. Our response.
Such are the men who seek your face, O Lord.
He shall receive blessings from the Lord and reward from the God who saves him. Such are the men who seek Him, seek the face of the God of Jacob. Our response.
Such are the men who seek your face, O Lord.
A reading from the first letter of Saint John. Think of the love that the Father has lavished on us by letting us to be called God's children. And that is what we are, because the world refused to acknowledge Him. Therefore, it does not acknowledge us. My dear people, we are already the children of God. But what we are to be in the future has not yet been revealed. All we know is that when it is revealed, we shall be like Him, because we shall see Him as He really is. Surely, everyone who entertains this hope must purify himself, must try to be as pure as Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Gospel acclamation.
Sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah to the Lord. Sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah to the Lord. Sing His praise, sing His praise. Sing hallelujah to the Lord. Let my soul rejoice in the King, as to Him our praises we bring. singing of His mighty deeds among us. He is Lord, He is Lord, and by all creation adored. He chose us as a people all His own. Sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah to the Lord. Sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah to the Lord. Sing His praise, sing His praise. Sing hallelujah to the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
Seeing the crowds, Jesus went up the hill. There he sat down and was joined by his disciples. Then he began to speak. This is what he taught them. How happy are the poor in spirit. Theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Happy the gentle, they shall have the earth for their heritage. Happy those who mourn, they shall be comforted. Happy those who hunger and thirst for what is right, they shall be satisfied. Happy the merciful, they shall have mercy shown them. Happy the pure in heart, they shall see God. Happy the peacemakers, they shall be called sons of God. Happy those who are persecuted in the cause of right, theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Happy are you when people abuse you and persecute you and speak all kinds of calumny against you on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear friends, today the Church celebrates All Saints' Day, a day when we remember all those canonized and those not canonized, but who have lived holy lives. We ask them to intercede for us and to help us live better lives. The month of November, my dear friends, the 1st of November and the 2nd of November, begins with two important feasts which actually helps us focus on our lives, to think more deeply about our journey on this earth, and also to understand our relationship with those who have gone before us. Pope Francis beautifully describes this feast as a feast of a family party. And when I was trying to understand what he was actually trying to say, I realized he was talking about the communion of those living and those who have gone before us. We though are away from each other, are still in communion with each other. And this day becomes a day for celebration for all of us. My dear friends, the Feast of All Saints' Day also coincides with this celebration of Halloween Day, a day which begins one day before the All Saints' Day And I was just trying to read a little more about it. It says that it begins on the eve of 31st of October and the celebration continues till the 2nd of November. And what is this celebration all about? During this celebration, people have got an idea that these are the days when the ghosts, the evil spirit are away. And that is why in order to replicate that entire feeling, we see individuals coloring their faces with different colors as if they were a ghost. No, moving around, celebrating. When I was trying to read more about this Halloween celebration, I came across one reflection, one story, in fact, which clearly gives us an idea of who saints are. And this priest who is describing this entire celebration of Halloween says that it is like God moving into a garden, picking up a pumpkin from the garden. He washes it nicely. He makes sure that he is cutting off all those things which are not essential, cleaning the inside part, and then allowing his spirit to go through this pumpkin and illumine the pumpkin so that anybody looking at that pumpkin will not see it as something which is dirty and dead, but something which gives light. And I think this precisely is what a life of a saint is all about. Individuals who are taken from their real context, who are washed, cleansed, who are helped to understand what are the things which is not good, and when they allowed God's Spirit to take charge, they became ambassadors of God. My dear friends, in the year 1969, on 16th July, three astronauts was sent to the moon when Apollo 11 was being launched. That time, before the launch, the CFR, the Code of Federal Regulations, they came up with a norm, rather a law, with 14 sections and 1,211 stipulations, giving in details that if these individuals would go and meet any of these alien people, they will have to immediately inform the government. And then they would be quarantined so that the influence on their bodies is not carried on to anybody else. So from 1969 till 1991, they realized that this law was not actually, useful. Because when these people came back and, there was no real effect. When we are trying to understand this entire law in the context of All Saints Day, we realize that we Christians, we believe in the intercession of individuals who have gone before us. And we believe that they are in heaven. Nobody would be able to explain as to how this intercession happens. But it is true. And it can be certified. Because the church, before canonizing an individual as a saint, has got so many stringent procedures to be followed that at every step it has to be complemented with a miracle. A miracle through the intercession of these saints. So my dear friends, today, when we look into our lives, we ask ourselves, if those people, simple people, could be saints, can I also be like them? And today, once we look into the lives of saints right from the first century, we see the saints were heroes in their own field. There were some people who were intellectuals and they became saints. There were some people who were close to nature and they became saints. There were some people who were fighting for a cause and they became saints. There were some people who believed that being a saint means being cheerful, like Don Bosco, Philip Neri. They became saints. So God is asking us today to look into our own lives and see which is that area which I would like to work on and contribute in building God's kingdom. So that I also in my own life, being an original, can become a saint. I think God does not need duplications. I need to imitate somebody in his austerity and I need to become a saint. Today God is asking me to look into my own life and see the area where I want to contribute in building God's kingdom. My dear friends, some of the reflections taken from the homily of Pope Francis ever since he became a pope, just as I have already mentioned, he calls this feast as the feast of a family party, a family celebration. And he also makes a clear, explicit mention of all those saints, holy men and women who have not been canonized. And he says, thanks to all these saints who live in our families, who have helped God move the world. I think these are powerful words. And that is why I wrote it down as it was spoken by Pope Francis. It is so paradoxical. How can we help God? But Pope Francis says, thanks to these common people in their real life, in their daily life, have lived normal lives but still in relationship with God, who today stand out as examples for us. My dear friends, this feast gives us a glimpse of what we can be in future. And in the end, let us not forget, this pilgrim church is in communion with the heavenly church. And on the feast of All Saints Day, and when we remember all the souls who have gone before us, let us once again remind ourselves that we are not alone in our journey. There are saints who have gone before us, interceding for us, so that we too one day may reach that place where they have reached. Let us ask God's Spirit to be with us. Let us profess our faith in God. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Heavenly Father, We, the church militant, relying on the blessings and prayers of the church triumphant, the legion of saints in heaven, ask you to heed the prayers of your children as we honor the memory of all saints.
Our response to each petition will be, Lord, may the saints intercede for us.
Lord, may the saints intercede for us.
We pray for our Holy Father, our bishops, priests, religious and laity, who help us and guide us by their faith, teachings and good example, that they may find strength through prayer and the life of sacrifice dedicated to your service. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, may the saints intercede for us.
We pray for all those going through difficult moments during this pandemic, that by our lives of love and self-giving, they may be drawn to Lord's loving care. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, may the saints intercede for us.
We pray for our youth, that they may emulate the lives of the saints who have lived and died before us, going through the same struggles that we face today and succeeding in setting examples of holiness for us to emulate. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, may the saints intercede for us.
We pray for more vocations to the religious and priestly life, that many young people may choose to follow in the footsteps of the apostles and saints who have dedicated their lives to holiness and service. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, may the saints intercede for us.
We pray for all those participating in the Eucharist virtually, that they may pledge their heartfelt devotion to Lord our God and walk in the light of Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, may the saints intercede for us.
Let us pray for our local and personal needs. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, may the saints intercede for us. Lord, we place these and all the other petitions that we have prayed for in the secret of our heart. We ask you to condescend to hear our prayers and grant them if they are according to your holy plan for us. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
We offer you, O Lord divine, our humble gifts of bread and wine. We place them on your altar, Lord, today. Make them worthy of your love. Send your blessings from above. Sanctify these gifts, O Lord, we pray. Take our hearts, take our minds, take all we have, make them thine, O Lord. Take all we have and make them
pray, dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May these offerings we bring in honor of all the saints be pleasing to you, O Lord, and grant that, just as we believe the saints to be already assured of immortality so we may experience their concern for our salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For today, by your gift, we celebrate the festival of your city, the heavenly Jerusalem, our mother, where the great array of our brothers and sisters already give you eternal praise. Towards her, we eagerly hasten as pilgrims advancing by faith, rejoicing in the glory bestowed upon those exalted members of the Church, through whom you give us, in our frailty, both strength and good example. And so we glorify you with the multitude of saints and angels, as with one voice of praise we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, earth is full of your glory. Glory fills the heavens too. Sing to him, Hosanna. Blessed is the one who comes, bringing this great glory. Holy, holy, holy Lord, sing to him, Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Oswald our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our benefactors, our friends, relatives, grandparents, parents, brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
We now make a spiritual communion with the Lord. O Lord Jesus, since I cannot now receive you in your sacramental presence, I beg you to come spiritually into my soul, to enrich me with your holy grace and make me truly your own forever. O Jesus, living in Mary, come and live in me. In the spirit of your holiness, in the fullness of your power, in the communion of your mysteries, in the perfection of your ways. O divine guest, give to my soul a strong, lively faith, an unbounded trust, perfect humility, an abiding sorrow for my sins, a total abandonment to your divine will, and a perfect loving union with you in mind and heart. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Lord Jesus, thank you for the blessings and graces you have given me through this spiritual communion.
Darkness bright, who will bear my
Let us pray. As we adore you, O God, who alone are holy and wonderful in all your saints, we implore your grace so that coming to perfect holiness in the fullness of your love, we may pass from this pilgrim table to the banquet of our heavenly homeland. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Parish notices, 1st November 2020, All Saints Day. October was the month of the Holy Rosary. We thank all the individuals and family who brought Our Lady to their homes and received graces from her. Let us continue to intercede to our Mother that she keeps us safe in her mantle of care. Today we celebrate the solemnity of All Saints Day. Let us ask the Lord for the grace that we too may attain holiness in life like the saints and emulate their examples. Monday, 2nd November is All Souls Day. We will have only one Mass uploaded on YouTube. All the Mass intentions will be read before the Mass. Please note that Salvation Dadar Cemetery will be open for visits on 1st and 2nd November from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. to avoid crowding. Please cooperate with the authorities to make the graveyards more prayerful, safe and clean. Do follow the rules of wearing masks, maintaining social distance, avoiding large gatherings and no burning of candles. Friday, 6th November is the first Friday of the month. We also commence the novena in preparation of our parish feast. The novena masses will be animated by the assigned communities. Let us, as one parish family, attend the virtual Eucharist and prepare ourselves spiritually. During this lockdown, we continue with our Bible classes virtually. Marathi Bible classes will be on Mondays from 7:30 p.m. to 8:30 p.m. Kindly contact Mr. Prosper D'Souza to receive the link to the same. English Bible sessions will be held at 7 p.m. every Wednesday. We live stream the Bible class on YouTube. Kindly contact Mr. Samson Francis to receive the link. Pre-baptism sessions will be held in the month of November. Kindly note, the first session will be held on Wednesday, 4th November 2020. Contact the parish office for further details. We will continue to pray for the victims of the coronavirus, our healthcare workers and volunteers who risk their lives to attend to those affected by the virus. The government, both at the national and state levels, municipality and police, for their efforts. May the Lord continue to inspire them in this difficult task. We will continue to play our part by staying at home and being safe and healthy. The daily masses will be uploaded on the YouTube in the following week. Kindly contact your parish council member or the area coordinator for the link. Special thanks to Macklin and the team for the recording, editing and YouTube relay of our masses on Saturday and Sunday. Let us take great care of the health of our seniors and children. If you need any assistance from the church, please contact the parish priest. Signed, Parish Priest, Father James Negrel, SDB. Prayer for protection. Almighty and merciful God, who show your love to all creation everywhere, hear graciously the prayers we make for all those affected by the coronavirus in the various parts of the world. We come before you asking for a quick control of the outbreak, for a healing of those affected, for the victims and their families. We pray for the doctors doing research that an effective vaccine to combat the sickness is speedily found. We pray for the government and health authorities that they take appropriate steps for the good of the people. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Blessing of Mary, help of Christians. Our help is in the name of the Lord,
who made heaven and earth.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
We fly to your patronage, O Holy Mother of God. Despise not our petitions in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin. Mary, help of Christians,
pray for us.
O Lord, hear my prayer,
and let my cry come unto you.
The Lord be with you,
and with your spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, who by the cooperation of the Holy Spirit did prepare the body and soul of the glorious Virgin Mother Mary to become a worthy dwelling for your Son, grant that as we rejoice in her commemoration, we may, by her loving intercession, be delivered from present evils and from everlasting death. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessings. May God, the glory and joy of the saints, who has caused you to be strengthened by means of their outstanding prayers, bless you with unending blessings.
Amen.
Freed through the intercession from present ills and formed by the example of their holy way of life, may you be ever devoted to serving God and your neighbor.
Amen.
So that together with all, you may possess the joys of the homeland where Holy Church rejoices, that our children are admitted in perpetual grace to the company of the citizens of heaven.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
You are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a dedicated people that should show forth the praises of Him who has called you out of darkness into His marvelous light, into His marvelous light. So come and sing Alleluia, praise to the Lord. Come on and sing the praises of Him, for He has called you out of darkness into His marvelous light, into His marvelous light.